Hello and welcome to the Red Tunic. So today we're going to make a nice bag that any cool streamer would be proud to have his shopping in if he's going out with his lovely wife. So first you need to cut out a bottom piece which is 5.5 inches by 13 inches. Some sort of dark blue would be perfect. The middle section is 5.5 inches by 13 inches again. I've made the bottom part slightly longer and I'll trim that down. And the top part is 6 inches by 13.5 inches. And what we're going to do is we're going to sew these together at the seam lines, 1/4 of an inch in, to make one nice big piece. So we've sewn all these pieces together and we've done it with 1/4 inch seam on both sides, and then we've made sure that we've ironed them flat. The reason we iron them flat is so that whenever we put something onto it or put it together, it's going to sit and hold a lot better. Now, I just happened to have a silk Capstar that I'd made where the background hadn't worked particularly well. So I've cut it out and I'm going to apply that onto the blue-red blue. You can leave it just as a blue-red blue, that's not a problem. But I thought the Capstar would be a nice little addition to it. So I'm going to applique it round about the edges of it just to secure it to the blue-red blue. And the other part that we're going to do is we've cut out a full size of the side. So this is the backing, or it's the back side of it. And it's just a piece of old denim skirt. And we've done 2 strips of red, because obviously Jeff is 2nd Battalion and that's what he likes. And we're going to applique these on into the centre. Okay, and we'll be back in a minute. Now, as you can see, we've appliqued the Capstar onto the blue-red blue, so that's all ready to go. Don't worry if it crinkles up a bit. By the time you put the guttering on and everything else around about it, the weight will pull it out, so it'll be standing nice and proud. We've also appliqued the 2 red ones on to make it 2nd Battalion. And again, that'll pull itself out once it's part of the bag as a whole. So it's nice and neat. Now what we're going to do is make the guttering. And that consists of 2 pieces of red fabric, which we're going to join onto a piece of denim. Now the piece of denim makes the bottom, the 2 red pieces will make the side guttering. Okay, and we'll be back in a minute. So we've sewn these together and we've got 1 side which you measure up, and don't forget to add in your 1/4 of an inch for your seam allowance. The bottom part was the denim and we've put 1/2 inch seam allowance because it's 1/4 of an inch on either side, and then we've got the other side of red and that's got 1/4 inch down at the bottom. You're also going to have a seam allowance up at the top of it, but all the figures will be written up. Okay, and that makes 1 long guttering piece like that, which will go around the bag. Now next, we're going to make the handles. And we take a piece of fabric and we iron in 1/4 of an inch at the bottom and 1/4 of an inch at the top. And then we'll put those 2 folded over. And it's easier if you use an iron with it and just iron it flat, because we're going to sew along this line to close it up and sew along this line here on the fold, just to make it stronger. It doesn't matter about the 2 ends because they're going to go into the bag itself, and we'll make 2 of those and we'll give you the measurements for them in a second. And your dimensions for these are the guttering in total in length is 47 inches and the width is 8 inches. So that includes all your seam allowances, so you have to make sure that you get absolutely bang on for that, because it'll fit around the front and the back of the bag. Your handles are 18 inches by 3 inches, so, and that includes your seam allowance in there. And then you just fold them in, iron them, and then fold them over, iron them again, and then we're going to go away and sew these all together. Okay, so for just now, we're just going to recap on the sizes that we should have so far. And we've got a piece that is 16 inches by 13 inches, just slightly over on that one, which isn't too bad, and that's fine because we can incorporate that in whenever we put the bag together. Blue red blue's been sewn together, don't forget your seam allowances. This piece is the same. And because I've used the edge of the skirt, I've already got a hemmed edge in there, so I don't have to worry about that. So that's all ready to go. Our handles are now 18 inches by 1 inch, as you can see. So they started off as 3 inches, they're now down to 1 inch. Okay, and I've used nice red thread on that so that it will show up as a blue, red, blue as well. Now, on the guttering it was 47 inches. And we made that into a blue, red, blue, like so. And we've opened up the seams so it lies nice and flat. Now, there are two schools of thoughts. One is that if you open up the seams, it weakens the seam. But your sewing machine is going to like it better going through less fabric on either side than having four pieces or three pieces of fabric on one side and one on the other. So we open the seams up here. For the lining, I've cut some scrap black satin that I had. Now, you can either baste this onto it or tack it, whichever you feel. If you're American, you'll baste it. If you're British, you'll tack it. Or you can just pin it together in places just to hold it together while you put the whole lot in sync. And then the lining also goes onto the backs, so make sure you get it the right way up. And I've used the self-edge at the top of the satin to use for the top of the bag, which gives me less work to do. And we're all for less work. So you tack or baste that onto that one. And on your other side, which is your back, we're gonna tack or baste another piece onto that one. Now bear in mind that this is gonna be the inside of the bag, so you want your right side to be showing. So it's the two wrong sides that go together. Okay, because your inside is gonna be nice and black that way. You can use any type of fabric you want. I could have used denim to do this. I can use anything that's a scrap piece of fabric lying around and it'll be absolutely fine. So we're gonna tack all these together and then put the handles on and show you how to make the bag into one piece. Okay, so what we've done with the guttering is we've got the central part, which is gonna be the bottom of the bag, is in denim. The two side parts are in red. And the inside lining is in, and it's black satin. And we've just taken a quarter inch and pinned it all and ironed it so that we get a nice fine line on it. And we're just going to run a straight stitch down each side and then we can put the bag together. Okay, so what we've done so far is we've got the guttering around the outside of the back part of the bag. And as you can see, we've done two or three lines of sewing down either side just to reinforce it. And these parts at the corner, because the sewing machine won't take it, we'll do them in by hand. And we just flip them over like that to make them nice and neat, but they'll be done by hand. On the inside, you can see the lining's already in place. And when it comes to putting the front part on, we'll be putting that on. I'll just show you at the top because it's easier. If you take your lining part, which should be right sides out, put it onto the seam and then fold the seam over and you're sewing down that line there. And it's what gives you the ridge on the outside. So it gives you more strength to the bag. Okay, so that's the last part that we're going to put into here. And then after that, we're onto the handles. So now we've put the whole bag together, we've attached the handles, as you can see. And it's all complete. With the handles, we've just put them onto the inside. So as you can see, they're held on two places and there's double seam sewn all the way around the top so that it keeps it really nice and secure. Nice sturdy bag. And Jeff has already been out and been using it to get his bottles of port. So if you want to make your own, feel free. And just remember to mention the red tunic. Thank you.